Good morning, class 12. So I really hope that you are doing pretty well. And today is Saturday, although weekend, but still, you need to always gear up yourself for your studies because this is your board class. I know little casualness would be there, but as I mentioned right now, as I said, you need to speed up yourself, accelerate yourself, right? So let's continue the chapter Law Spring, which we started it. We started the first part from the Law Spring. Sometimes I find a rupee in the garbage. Story of Sahib-e-Alam, who was a rag picker, living in Simapuri area. So if you remember the last part, which we read or in which we discussed, was about that Anees Jung, when she met the army of barefoot boys, they gave different excuses of not wearing the chappals, right? And then she mentioned that this is the perpetual state of poverty, as I would say, like this is the line here, right? So now let's continue here. Now this next paragraph is related to something like the slippers and the footwear only. So let's try to understand what it's written. I'm reading a full paragraph and then I'm going to explain this one, right? I remember a story a man from Udupi once told me. As a young boy, he would go to school past an old temple where his father was a priest. He would stop briefly at the temple and pray for a pair of shoes. Now this you need to mark it. I am marking it again. Pair of shoes. 30 years later, I visited his town, which was now drowned in an air of desolation. Now it means like people are busy in their own world. In the backyard where lived the new priest, there were red and white plastic chairs. A young boy dressed in a grey uniform, wearing socks and shoes, arrived painting and previous school bag on a folding bed. Looking at the boy, I remembered the prayer another boy had made to the goddess when he had finally got a pair of shoes. Let me never lose them. Now, this is also important. Let me never lose them. The goddess had granted his prayer. Young boys like the son of the priest now wore shoes, but many others like the rag pickers in my neighborhood remained shoeless. Now, see what happened. Now, she related with the rag picker boys, those who were not wearing the shoes. So she said that once she heard about a story from the Udupi person, it was like there was a boy who was the son of a priest. He prayed that he should have a pair of shoes, and he finally got two also, and he thanks to the God while praying it and said, I will never lose them. And this is after 30 years later, once again visited the same place. Now the new another priest, obviously 30 years passed on, then the priest of that son, another child, he had a pair of shoes, but when he came from the school, he very casually, he had thrown the things here and there, like socks, shoes, uniform, bag, because he was not giving the respect to those things which he already had. And the earlier priest son, 30 years ago, who had nothing, he prayed for it. And when he got it, he said, I would never lose them. Because that person, that child was not having, but now the people, those who are having, they cherish it. They don't cherish it actually. So now Anees Jung related with it. But still the situation is similar. Although the priest's son was wearing, but still there are the rag pickers in my neighboring area, those who are shoeless. So means 30 years back also there was a poverty thing. They were the thing which people can't afford. And the same thing is here right now. So here in this para, she related with that thing. Clear? Okay. So next about it says, my acquaintance with the barefoot rag pickers lead me to Simapuri. So means as she was connected with those rag pickers boys, she went to Simapuri area, a place in the periphery of Delhi, yet miles away from it. Now periphery here means on the border, the outskirts of the Delhi, but still it was very, very far away. So you need to underline from here, from this line basically, even 2 marks or 5 marks question can come. And there you need to describe Simapuri. It is metaphorically, right? Those who live here are squatters who come from Bangladesh back in 1971, which we have already discussed here, right? Sahib's family is among them. Sima Puri was then a wilderness. It still is, but it is no longer empty. So this place earlier used to be empty, but now those people were living who came from Dhaka. In structures of mud with roofs of tin. Now this is the description of that place. So we need to understand. Structures of mud, roofs of tin, tarpaulin, devoid of sewage, drainage, running water. These problems were there, but still 10,000 rag pickers used to live there in that pitty condition. They have lived here for more than 30 years without an identity. You need to underline it, without an identity. Yeah, I'm marking it again here, without an identity. Without permits, but with ration cards that get them names on voter list and enable them to buy grain. So Anisu mentioned they were having no identities, but yes, they were having ration cards so that they can purchase the grains. Their names were written. Food is more important for survival than an identity. Please underline, food is more important. A question can come that for those rag pickers, food was more important than creating their identity. And it's very obvious. People can't sleep empty stomach, empty bellies. For them, creating an identity was not that important, but fulfilling their basic needs were more important. Right? This is the line here. I would say it here, this one. If at the end of the day, we can feed our families and go to bed without an aching stomach, we would rather live here than in the fields that give us no grain. So she said, Anisang, what people thought about there is, at the end of the day, our main thing is that family should feed themselves. They should not eat, sleep empty stomach, as I mentioned. Says a group of women in tattered saris when I asked them why they left their beautiful land of green fields and rivers. Then she described about that, how the women were saying about it. Wherever they find food, they pitch their tents that become transit homes. Now, transit homes, like transit means temporary. Now, people say that whenever they are or wherever they are getting the food, they try to make their homes their only. Children grow up in them, becoming partners in survival. So, for those people, for the elders, children are the partners in survival. For survival in Sima Puri means rag picking. If you need to survive, you need to do rag picking. Through the years, it has acquired the proportions of a fine art. Garbage to them is gold. Very important. Garbage to them is gold. Now, gold, as I mentioned, not that one, which you are, that ornament which you are wearing it. It's about that they are finding the things which are useful to them, from which they can fulfill their stomach. It is their daily bread, a roof over their heads, even if it is a leaking roof, but a child, it is even more. So whatever they are finding here, they are even selling it, they have been eating it, and still they are getting a chance to live. I guess this much is clear to everyone here. No doubt till here. So this last portion we can cover up in the next class. So please send the worksheet timely. Do it. God bless you all. Any doubts, please clear it out and read the last portion too. Or if you want, I can cover up here also. So it's better we can cover up here, right? I sometimes find a rupee, even a 10 rupee note. So it's better we can cover up in the next class. So thank you everyone. God bless you.